Welcome back to Everyday Cycling, a place where we talk about riding bikes as a way to lead a simpler and happier lifestyle. I am Victor, and today we are back at the Georgia Tech campus at a student-organized bike shop called Stotter Bikes. I'm happy that they allowed me to record this video here. Being able to eventually use their space and their tools will be a huge enabler for some of the videos I want to make. I'll talk more about this place in a different video, because today's topic is going over some truly useful upgrades for the Brompton. Let's start by getting this bike on the stand and giving it a quick clean. As you may know, I've been using this Brompton Electric for the past month and it just got a bit dirty. I'll spray it down with some of this pink stuff that I think is cleaning fluid, grab the cleanest rag that I can find and just take some of this dirt off. It doesn't have to be perfect, just good enough for us to get started on the upgrades. We are going to start here on the cockpit, then make our way down and to the back. The first accessory is a rear view mirror called Mirrycle. I've been using this mirror on different bikes for over 9 years. The way this thing is attached to the bike is by sticking this part inside of the handlebar. By screwing this bolt, these plastic pieces come together and lock inside of the tube. To install this on the Brompton, it's clear we're gonna have to do something about this grip and cut a hole through it. Using a knife to cut through the rubber is a good start, but there is some hard plastic underneath. Now that it's properly modified, we can put it back on the bike and install the mirror. I like installing it upside down as it doesn't affect the folding and you can still see quite well. After folding the bike, if you want, you can give it a little twist and it stays completely out of the way. Next up is the KLICKfix quad adapter. I came across this product on a previous video where I installed a bottle cage that used this mounting system. Since then, I realized that I can use the same mount to hold a variety of other stuff, like my vlogging camera, making this one of my favorite accessories. This is not very intuitive to install, so looking at the installation instructions can be quite helpful. I've done this before, so let's jump into it. This metal strip goes around the stem, through this metal clip, and we fold it back up. I like to roll some electrical tape around it to make it all black, but it's a personal thing. Now we install the actual mount, and we use a bolt to lock the mount to the steel plate. As we tighten the bolt, it tensions the steel band and locks everything into place. Now we need to assemble the other side of the mount to whatever it is that we want to carry. The mounting procedure is basically the same, so I'm going to spare you the details and show you what it looks like in the end. And here it is installed on the selfie stick that I use with my 360 camera. With a single hand, you can take it from the handlebar or put it back on. You can mount anything you find useful, whether it's an umbrella handle, a bike pump, a bike lock, or even a lunch bag if you use a different type of block. There is a lot of ways to get creative with this thing, and that's why I like it. Moving down on the stem, let's have easy clamp springs installed on this bike. I've covered these springs in a previous video, they're super easy to install and they're really helpful to keep the clamp aligned when screwing or unscrewing the hinges. This is definitely not an essential item, but it's a nice touch. The next one is one of my favorites and it's also been featured on this channel before, and it's the X-Roller wheel extender. To install it, we first need to remove the original wheels. When mounting the extender, make sure the extendable axle is on the right-hand side. Then we need to screw the bolts on both sides, keeping the wheel extender straight up. There are some very small socket screws that go in here and keep these lugs into place. Make sure you tighten them up too. Once everything is solid, just reinstall the wheels. The left side is straightforward, but the right side requires a 9mm wrench to prevent the extendable axle from rotating while you're tightening the wheel. Note how the wheel extender snaps into place when it's extended or fully retracted. Some people ask me if there's any risk of it extending by itself, and it sure does not. This thing is rock solid. The next upgrade is the Brompton rear rack. This is one of the things I've missed the most on the Brompton Electric thus far. That's for a few reasons, and this is the first one.
I finished doing my groceries, still need to check out, but the way this bike is set up with just the mud guards, no rack. Look at this noise. Yeah, I'll definitely have to do something about this to use this bike for grocery shopping.
The second reason is because I wanted to increase the amount of cargo I can carry on it, so having a rear rack is an obvious option. I can go back to using my Vincita bag for groceries, since it fits the rear rack so nicely. Finally, look how the rear light is originally set up in a way that it's partially blocked by the wheel. So having a rear rack allows us to reposition the rear light to an unobstructed place. I'll show you how it looks like in the end. Installing the rear rack involves removing the rear wheel, replacing the rear fender by a different version, mounting the rack, repositioning the rear light, and fitting the wheel back into place. As you can see, it's quite involved, and here's how it looks like in the end. Look at the rear light and how much easier it'll be to be noticed from the back. Great! Let's make this bike even better to roll around by replacing the original wheels by the Brompton EZ-Wheels. I took these off my other bike so they're not brand new, but it would definitely make rolling the Brompton a bit smoother. Combined with a wheel extender and a rack, this Brompton Electric is now exactly how I want it. Now that I'm considering using the rear rack for cargo, or even having a bag mounted on it, I need a way to keep the bike standing up without having to flip the rear wheel under. For that, I'll be using a dedicated kickstand. This one is from Silverock. It attaches to the wheel axle and rack bolt on the left side of the bike. Installing it requires removing the axle nut and also the rack bolt, put the kickstand in and stack everything back in the right order. Make sure the kickstand is installed over the wheel washer and not directly in contact with the frame. Although it was presumably designed for the Brompton, the results were quite... well, let me show you.
You know what, I don't know if I'm completely satisfied with that kickstand. The bike is pretty unstable. Like here I have the bag and it's empty. If I put the handlebars straight, the bike just tips over. It doesn't stay up. I need to rotate the handlebar in that direction for the bike to stay up. If I put some weight in here, it doesn't hold up. So what I'll try to do is disassemble this thing. I know that there's a hole that secures this lower leg in place. I'll see if I can make a second hole a little bit higher and maybe gain like 1 centimeter or 1.5 centimeters in length. And that should make the bike a little bit more stable. Just finished modifying the kickstand. Now the bike is stable. The bag is now full of stuff. I have my power drill, my tripod, everything in here. I can turn the handlebar in either direction and the bike just stays up. So if you're considering something like this, keep in mind that you're probably gonna have to do the same modifications I did if you wanna carry payload here at the front.
Now the Brompton Electric is exactly how I wanted it to be. There are a few more upgrades on the pipeline, so if you're into these, make sure you subscribe to this channel. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. And also, welcome to all new subscribers. We'll make a big giveaway on this channel once we reach 20,000. To all of you, thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.
We are done. I have the Brompton Electric exactly how I wanted it to be. The only thing I'm not happy about is this.